welcome! I'm Tom, Alchemy Wizard. Let's talk about gold and how this precious metal has been used throughout history to create the ultimate in immortality serums and how it's still used today in order to bring about immortality. Our journey begins in ancient Egypt and ancient China. The ancient Egyptians called it gold water, and they believed that because gold didn't oxidize and it just stayed perfect forever, that by drinking gold, they themselves could achieve immortality. And in Chinese culture, an ancient alchemist named Wei Boyang believed that by creating gold and drinking it would also bring about immortality. In 16th century France, the idea was revived, but unfortunately the method that the Chinese and the Egyptians used was lost. But an alchemist then created gold chloride, and he believed that by drinking gold chloride, you could obtain immortality. Sadly, gold chloride winds up to be a neurotoxin and not so good for the body. So a lot of people, in preserving their health, didn't actually preserve it for very long, especially those that took massive doses of the gold chloride. In the 17th and 18th century, a process called aurum potabile came about, and this actually started to produce the first colloidal nanoparticles. But the colloidal nanoparticles in it were very, very small, and it still contained gold chloride. And at that point, they realized that too much gold chloride is probably no good for the body. And so the amount that they consumed of this stuff was limited. However, with the colloidal gold content being so low, we're not so sure that anyone achieved any kind of immortality from this stuff. Now, back to the ancient Chinese and the ancient Egyptians, I can't find any reported information of people actually keeling over from the stuff that they made, which means they had a different process of making gold, drinking their gold back then, than the gold chloride that got discovered in the 16th century. Now, did any of the ancient Egyptians achieve immortality? Well, you know, there's speculation on that. I mean, the ancient gods were supposedly lived a really long time, but I don't see any mummies walking around these days. So, maybe they had a better solution for it, but it didn't bring about immortality either. The lack of immortality aside, by the ancient Egyptians, I do think that today we are on the cusp of figuring out how to create higher concentrations of colloidal nanoparticles with modern procedures that may actually do something. What about modern medicine today? Gold nanoparticles are used in very unique ways in medicine, and they're constantly looking for other more unique ways. But let me just show you something that I found out so far. So, gold nanoparticles can be used in some way that they can actually tell the presence of cancer cells in under 10 minutes. They are also researching putting gold nanoparticles on the tips of instruments to prevent infection, secondary infection from the instruments that they're using. It's quite fascinating the things that they're experimenting with in the medical industry with gold. Now, another process that they're actually working on is they take the gold nanoparticles and they're able to insert them into the tumors. The tumors suck the gold nanoparticles in. And then they heat them with the laser beam and the gold explodes like a nanoparticle grenade, destroying the tumor from the inside out. That is way cool stuff. Let's face it. Can we achieve immortality from this stuff? To be honest, I don't know. I think some forms of colloidal gold can make you feel better and perhaps reverse the aging process. There is not a lot of research in that matter, but I think there's something to the ancient idea with gold and how it interacts with the body at various levels. Certainly, the medical industry is extremely interested in colloidal gold, for its own purposes, if, you know, nothing else, as delivery agent for other pharmaceuticals and stuff. So, did I answer the question? Can we become immortal with colloidal gold? I don't know. You know, we're gonna have to see, you know, maybe in 200 years if I'm still walking around. Oh, maybe, you know. But if not, well, I'm sure alchemists after me and great scientists will investigate it and may uncover the nugget or the truth to colloidal gold and its possible immortality that it may contain. I'm Alchemy Wizard. I'm Tom. I'll talk to you again soon.